Stop.
Hello, what's up? This is your boy TJ. In this session, I'm talking about a motivation, school motivation. I know you're ready to go to school. I know your parents has provided for you all the necessary goods. I know your parents has provided for you your books, your school, your shoe, your everything that you need to go to school with. Your parents has provided them for you with the expectation that you will be serious, with an expectation that you will work harder, with an expectation that you will put all the effort to do something great. I want you to think that there are people, there are child out there, there are children, there are kids out there that don't have the opportunity that you have right now. So don't make use of it. Don't misuse the opportunity that you have right now. Don't misuse the platform that you have right now. Don't misuse it. When you have a parent that can provide for you, when you have a way, when you have an opportunity to go to a private school, when you have a parent that can provide for you, that simply means that you should say thank you, God. Because we have 80% of kids out there that don't have the way, the manner, and the means. So you need to work hard. Your parent bought you a new iPhone. Your parent bought you an expensive laptop just for you to study. And what you do is that you are using that cell phone to go online instead of you to study. And you still wonder why that kid that is struggling, that kid, that parent is selling at the Abacha Street or whatever place in Sierra Leone, and you still wonder why those kids are still beating you in class. They beat you over and over again because they don't have time to go to WhatsApp, they don't have time to go to Facebook. All they got is their book. Even to buy the book, it's trouble to buy the book. They don't have a way, they don't have the means and the way to buy a smartphone. So you have a smartphone, you can use that smartphone to be better than them, because with that smartphone, you can do research. With that laptop, you can do research. You can able to add to the explanation that your teacher has taught you when you are not doing that. You are not making good use of your opportunity. You are making that opportunity in a bad way. You are using opportunity in a bad form. Instead of you to be studying, you are using that opportunity to go into the social media, WhatsApp. Why are you going to the WhatsApp or social media when you should be studying? In September, school has reopened and you need to pile yourself up. So listen to me very closely. This is number one step that I want to teach you today. I want to teach you that. Number one, you need to know your why. Why should I study harder? Why should I put in an effort? Why should I put in all my energy to study harder? Why should I be discreet? Think about your mother. Think about your father. Think about your grandmother. They all expect you to be great. They all expect you to be brilliant. So they put you in school for you to do that. You might not have a father, you might not have a mother, you might not have somebody to provide for you. You need to study harder for you to be able to provide for your kids, so your kids will not go through the same things that you go through. So your kids will not struggle the way you have to struggle. So you need to put on your effort. Don't say, because I did not brought up in a community that they have some other school. I was born in the eastern part of Freetown. I was born in the central part of Freetown, an area or a community where we have all sorts of people there. Forget about your community. Your community is not a reason for your dropout. Your situation is not a reason for your dropout. You need to work hard. You need to go through everything. Think about people that have done it, that you can do it. Think about people that have done it, that you can do it. Even Francis Ben Kalfala, who is now the commissioner right now, the ACC boss right now, he done it, that you can do it. If the commissioner Francis Ben Kalfala can do it, that you can do it. If the president Bio can do it, that you can do it. If other people can do it, then you can do it. There is no way, no excuse for you not to do it. And number two, principle I want to tell you right now before you start to go to school. Number two, principle I want to tell you right now that you start to go to school is for you not to allow any knot to slip. When you allow your knot to slip, when you allow your knot to slip, it made me, you would find it difficult. The reason why you are an average student right now is because you only study during examination. You only study for examination. You only study because you have an examination. That's not learning. That's not learning. Learning takes place when you read every day, when you do research every day, when you try to dig into what you've been taught, when you try to know more. That's what learning started. Learning starts from when you want to know more. Learning starts from when you want to know exactly what the teacher is talking about. When the teacher taught you in school, when the teacher taught you in the classroom, what you need to do more is that you need to go to the lab, you need to go to the computer, you need to use your phone, you know, use your cell phone, you need to search what the teacher taught you, you need to learn more. That's where our learning takes place. Don't only study when you have an examination. You can never learn anything from that. Number three principle I want to tell you right now, right today, before you start school 2019, 2020, before you start school 2020, my number three principle I want to tell you is never, never follow peer group influence. My number three principle I want to tell you, never follow peer group influence. Never follow peer group influence. Never in your whole life follow peer group influence. I'm telling you this today because peer group influence can motivate you in the wrong way. When you go to school, you see your friend is having a big phone, an iPhone, and you don't know how that your friend possessed that iPhone, and you want to have that iPhone. But what you do is that you follow that your friend in all sorts of ways, then you become your mindset and your purpose in school starts changing. That's not the way. For you to be who you want to be, for you to be focused in school, you need to hold it. Your mindset to only be in school. I'm not saying you should not make friends. I'm not saying you should not mingle in class. I'm not saying you should not be with your whole friends. You can be with your friends, but you need to focus. That's the primary focus. Your mother is at the market selling. Your father is at the workshop working. Your father is working very, very hard. Your mother is working very, very hard. They are going through hell to provide for you. And what you are doing when you're going to school, you training bad influence. That's not you. That's not you. You are not that. You are meant for a better purpose. You need to find your better purpose. You need to choose your people that you mingle with. You need to choose the type of friend that you have. You should not be pumped up by everything. You should not be pumped up by everybody. You need to choose your circle. It's my first and the final point that I want you to learn right now when you are going to school, when you are starting 2019, 2020 academic year. You need to be forced in the last entire morning. You need to know sense of urgency. Your sense of urgency should be accurate. Wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning. We always be before time. Stop saying this is the black man time. Stop saying I need to wait, I need to wait, I need to wait. No, you should have a sense of urgency. Be in school early, be in class early. Never miss lecture. Your sense of urgency should be in an accurate form. Your sense of urgency should always be. You should go to bed early and wake up early. Wake up at 3 o'clock. Most of the great people you see today, they woke up at 3 o'clock. This is the time for you to be serious. You cannot be 18 years for the rest of your life. You cannot be 16 years for the rest of your life. So you need to make use of the time that you have right now. You should not misuse the time that you have right now because of the funny things you see around you. education is the thing, the most powerful weapon in which you can use to change your life and the world. You can use education to change your life. You can use education to change the world. So you need to elevate your sense of urgency. You need to be urgent in doing anything. You need to be urgent. Do it in hurry. Forget about your background, whether you're rich or poor. Forget about it. What you need to do is you need to elevate your sense of urgency. So I want to leave you with this today. Make the best of the make the best of your life, the rest of your life. I want you to know I love you. Please subscribe to our channel. I love you so much. Thank you.